My name is Aban, and let's have a look of the exhibition. This is Pablo's photograph. This was just taken in 1977. The reason why it makes sense here is because how fragile Gandhi is today, how we are attacking him and his ideas, and how we have forgotten the value of all that he propagated, all that he advocated. And you know, we are fighting a lot, and I think we need to remember Gandhi. And taking that forward, we have Parthiv's work, where there are different icons, different visionaries that we have to keep together. So the title is Hum Ek The Aur Rahenge. So there's Rohit Vemula, just to give you an example, who's the Dalit scholar. There's Savitribai Phule, who started with, the first girls' school along with Fatima Sheikh. There's Jyotibai Phule, there's Ambedkar, there's Gandhi, of course, there's Gauri Lankesh, and there's Bhagat Singh. So the idea is to remember, to fight back, to get back the idea of India, like how we had, how our forefathers had envisioned, and how we have to take it forward. This work, if you see it from afar, you'll see the face, but if you zoom in, then you have these images of the protests that are taking place. So this is a very recent work where images of all protests that are happening against the CAA, the NRC and the MPR have been put together to form the face of Ambedkar. So this is by Ohida, and this is on the very current issue of what's happening in the country on the streets. And here, if you see, this is quite direct what it's trying to insinuate. Actually, it's directly telling you who is controlling the people and how there's an infighting between people. But in the middle are these reference to Shaheen Bagh protests, where there are women, and there's a placard saying "We the People," because Shaheen Bagh is about protecting the constitution, is about protecting democracy. And here, just to be direct, because it's always good to be direct in such circumstances, there's a pro-democracy movement placard. This work is by Gigi, and this is actually the hand, the finger of Ambedkar, where within it he's written the preamble, and where he's also defining these words. And the reason why I've placed it here is because it kind of goes inside and it points you to the direction. So this part of the exhibition is where I'm trying to explore the intellect of the constitution, how it came about, what are the strengths, what are the drawbacks, what has also been left from the constitution. So the constitution is a work in progress, and so this segment is exploring that. So this is by a very young photographer, Kashmiri photographer, Sana Irshad Matto. So there's this work which is terribly disturbing, where the person is wounded for pellet guns, which is absolutely barbaric, and it shouldn't be used against humans. It's been banned across the world, where it's not even used on animals, and here we are using it on our own people. And similarly, there's another here with the X-ray, where the woman has pellet guns, the bullets in her private part, and there's so many that it's so complicated that there's no surgery that they can do. Here, this work is very important because here, people believe that Kashmir is happy with the decision and there are no protests happening. But here Sana has shot a work where the date is written telling the world that nothing is normal in Kashmir, and the media is absolutely sold. The media is selling you false propaganda, and we in mainland need to really speak for them. We thought that it's very important that we do this, simply because first point is that it's 70 years of the constitution, so one has to really celebrate that fact, and the fact that a lot of constitutions have fallen and the countries haven't survived or gone in the direction. But in India, our forefathers had come up with this progressive document, and it still is there. Then we need to revisit the constitution, because there's, you know, it's a work in progress, so there are lots of debates around it. So we have to, in the spirit of debates, in the spirit of discourse, we need to continue that. And most importantly, right now, with all the developments that are happening in the country regarding CAA, NRC and PR, I think now is the time to defend the constitution. So the urgency to do this exhibition kind of amplified the moment we realized a lot of unconstitutional things are happening in the name of the constitution. So this exhibition became an important effort to take a collective stand, saying that, okay, we are heading in this direction and this seems incorrect or it seems a bit wrong. So we as a people are making a statement through our works. One part of the exhibition deals with the intellect of it, where the debate is happening, back and forth is happening. Then the second part of the exhibition is where the conflict side of it, that where the problems are, what, where we are absolutely lacking, where there are human rights violations. Then there's a third part to the exhibition where that area is basically where the documentations of the protests that are happening across the country. And there are paintings, there are sculptures, there are prints, there's illustration. There are some people who are not professional artists but have a lot of things to express. So they've also shown here. So it's a mixed bag. It's a lot of people from varied life. And there has been a conscious effort to have representation from the disadvantaged groups. Like there are Adivasi artists, there are Dalit artists, there are Muslim artists, there are women. And then we're trying to also expand it to include some artists from the Northeast. The way I see this exhibition currently working out is to involve more and more school children. That's why we've extended the exhibition, where we're trying to get a lot of school children so that they understand what the Constitution is and the debates around it. And also they should be part of the discourse. So here is an attempt to take it to the school children, to the college children, and keep the discourse alive. The Constitution is the utmost document of this country, and this is why I am an Indian citizen, why you are an Indian citizen. And it also has a global outlook. Like, we are not reduced to just a matter of being an Indian. We are global citizens, we have a place. And we also, it's a vision in the making, it's a vision that needs to be protected, it's a vision for a more equal world. So I think it's very important, it's more important than any religious book, it's more important than any other document for us as a society, as a country, and also beyond this country. I think that the vision in the Constitution is what we need to protect and we need to strive and we need to take forward.